Hello, I'm Suresh Vasugi, and I'm a professor in the Computer Science Department at Dartmouth. I focus on applied machine learning, specifically natural language processing. Our lab is currently focused on a project which deals with reducing political polarity, specifically on social media. The reason why our work is so important is because today, social media has become a big part of public life. For example, let's say one day someone tweets, "It's a cloudless day," and that person's friend writes, "It's actually a scorching day." Both people are talking about the same thing, but they're conveying it in a different way. The difference here is in the wording, or what is called the style of the text. Despite the content being about the same thing, which is the weather, the style of each text is different. Our project aims to reduce what is called political tribalism. People tend to group with others who are ideologically similar to themselves. For example, liberals tend to follow other liberals on social media. Conservatives tend to do the same thing. This is a big issue because it creates what are called filter bubbles or echo chambers. These are difficult to penetrate from the outside, but they're very good at propagating ideas that everybody agrees with in the group. Because it is very difficult to penetrate these filter bubbles, it becomes hard to introduce new ideas into them. One way to potentially tackle this problem of echo chambers is by depolarizing articles. For example, we can take an article written by someone who's right-wing about immigration and change its style, making it less polarizing. It still has the same content, but it has a different style. By taking on these kind of what are called style transfers, we hope to penetrate these chambers and introduce more neutral or centrist ideas that bring these bubbles together. We are really excited about this project because we are able to help depolarize the current political climate through technological means and hopefully foster a healthier public sphere.